Okay, I've started. So in dimensional analysis, one important formula, one principle it is there, na, that we call it as principle of homogeneity. And it is very important principle, na, na, and on this they will ask you objective questions more frequently. And it is very important. It is very, 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 very important principle. Okay, sir. What is this meaning of principle of homogeneity? What it tells, sir? Okay. So principle of homogeneity means, see, if we have one equation, let us imagine, a known equation, let us take. Okay. So that known equation is S is equal to ut plus half a t square. I'm taking. This is a known equation for you already. So this distance, s is the distance, u is gravity, t is time, a is acceleration. This is a known equation, very well known equation for all of you. Okay. Now, so this in this equation, it is having total three terms. It is having total three terms. Yes or no? Yes. First term, second term, third term. Okay. Principle of homogeneity says that in a composite equation like this, the dimensions of all the terms, this dimension, this dimension, this dimension, should be same. Clear? So what it is saying? In a composite physical relation, comma, the dimension of all the terms must be same, should be same, they should be same. Okay, clear? Okay, Anna? That means what are the dimensions of x? S means distance, its dimensions are nothing but L. Yes or no? Yes. Then let us take this dimension, U and T, UT dimensions. Okay? U means what? Velocity. Velocity dimensions what is L into T power minus 1. Yes or no? Meter per second. Velocity unit is? Velocity unit is meter per second. Meter means unit of length. Length dimension is L upon. Second is the dimensions of unit of time. Time dimensions are T. It can be written as L T power minus 1. Okay? That means U dimensions are L T power minus 1 into T dimensions are again T. So that means this T cancel. Yes or no? T power minus 1 into T power 1. T power minus 1 plus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. T power 0 is 1. Means L into 1. It is nothing but L. Yes. See, dimensions of S and dimensions of UT are same. You take dimensions of half AT square. Okay? Dimensions of AT square. Half also I am taking. Okay. Half is a dimensionless quantity. Dimensionless constant. It doesn't have any dimensions. That means we want dimensions of A and T. Okay, what is A, sir? A is nothing but unit is meter per second square. Meter dimensions is L. Second dimensions is T. Time dimensions is T. So T square means its dimensions are L upon T square into T square is the right. T square. So, this T square cancel will get L. Yes. See, dimensions of S, L, dimension of U and T, also L, dimensions of A, T square, also L. Okay? So, this is very important formula, it is very important principle, Nana. We have to use this principle. Clear? In any physical relation, in any equation, dimensions of all the terms, how many number of terms are there? That all the terms, dimensions should be same. That principle we call it as principle of homogeneity. Clear? Got it? If you want, I can show you with another example also. Okay? Let me take another example. So what is this another example? I'll take. V is equal to u plus at already we have discussed. What shall I take? Dimensions, principle of homogeneity. Okay? Got it, no?
Yeah.
Now how we will get a problem on the topic for JEE and NEET examination, how we will get problems on this. Okay? Yeah. Now I am giving you a problem. Let us imagine the equation is given as x is equal to AT. Here A is not acceleration. A is one unknown. Okay? Why A? You will get confusion. Alpha T. Okay? Here plus beta T cube is given for you. This is the equation given. Here they will mention here. Clear? Okay, na? So what I am saying, S is a distance, what is this one? T is time. Then find the dimensions of alpha and beta. They will ask. Okay, one equation is given, alpha t plus beta t cube. Just I have given randomly something. Okay, here x they are saying that it is a distance and t they are saying that it is a time. Then they are asking us to find dimensions of alpha and beta. Okay, now according to principle of homogeneity, what it is saying? Dimensions of x, dimensions of alpha t, dimensions of beta t cube, all must be same. Okay, yeah. So what are dimensions of S? L. Yes or no? Dimensions of S are L. Okay, clear? Alpha into dimensions of time are T. Correct. These two dimensions should be same. Clear? That means alpha will become L dimension upon T. That means L T power minus 1. These are the dimensions of alpha. Got it? Clear? Like this, you should proceed. Otherwise, just equate this like this. S should be equal to alpha T. Then alpha is equal to S upon T. Okay. I am writing dimensions of S. S means what they said? S means distance they said. Distance dimensions are L. T, what they said? Time. What they will say? That dimensions only you should take. That means L T power minus 1 are the dimensions of alpha. Okay. Now I am going to calculate dimensions of this. This S is equal to beta T cube. I don't know what is this beta. S upon T cube. Dimensions I am writing. L upon time cube. Time dimensions cube. Means L T power minus 3. Clear? So beta dimension should be this. Then only this equation is valid. Otherwise not valid. What is this beta? Beta is unknown. But what is alpha? Alpha may be velocity. Meter per second unit is. It may be velocity. Whereas beta is something unknown. We don't know. Meter per second square means acceleration. But again second is there. Something unknown. That dimension means that much. Okay, na? So it is very important. You must remember this, na? Like this, they will ask you questions on your objective examination. Okay, now I am going to take one example, na? Now I am going to take one example. that example I am taking from the exercise which I have given material to you. Okay, so page number 63, I am taking question number 26. Question number 26, page number 63. In this page number, second chapter, exercise, page number 63, question number 26 I am taking. Okay,
yes.
What is the question? See, question is, a force is given by, a force is given by F is equal to, okay, what they are given? AT plus BT square. Okay. Okay. Here, T is time. They mentioned. T means what time? F means force. Already they have mentioned. Okay. So here T is time they have mentioned. Now they are asking, find dimensions of A and B. Okay, four options they are given. Na, first option they are given is m l t power minus 3. This first and m l t power minus 4. This second. This is the first option. These are the dimensions of A, these are the dimensions of B, they said. Okay? I'll explain. Okay? Next, with this example, I am going to explain. Okay? They are asking that, sir, please explain one more time. I will explain with one. This example, I am explaining. Okay? Now, second option is M, L, T power minus 4, and this should be square bracket. This should be square bracket. And ml t power minus 3. Third option, ml t power minus 1 and ml t power minus 2. Fourth option, ml t power minus 2 and ml t power minus 1. These are the four options they have given. Okay, sir, repeat. Okay, so I am repeating, Nana. Initially is given that option A is right, sir. Okay, don't see now. Don't see, just listen here. Don't see your pages resolving. Don't divert from this concept. Don't divert your concentration. Listen here, sir. I am giving one question. A force is given by the equation F is equal to AT plus BT square. Here A and B are unknown. And he said that here T, in the sense, T is time they are saying. Find the dimensions of A and B they are asking. Means A and B are unknown. Whereas F is a known thing, force. Four options are given for us. Which is the right answer? So this can be solved by using the principle of homogeneity. So what is principle of homogeneity says? Principle of homogeneity says that dimensions of AT, dimensions of BT square, all three should be same. Dimensions of all these three terms should be same. So to find A, I am using F, should dimension should be equal to AT. Don't think that I am writing F is equal to AT. I am assuming that dimensions of F and AT should be same. Dimensions of F and AT should be same. Okay, bracket added in means dimension. Then what is A? A in a sense, dimensions of F upon dimensions of time. Clear? Okay? Yeah. So A value is equal to, A dimension should be equal to, F means what is 4. 4 means what is 4 formula is MA can be written. Yes or no? Means what is its unit? Unit is kg meter per second square, correct? Yes, that unit of force is kg meter per second square. Okay, na? Yeah, I am writing the dimensions of force. Force dimensions are kg is the unit of mass, and mass dimensions are m. Meter is the unit of length, and its dimensions are l. Second is the unit of time, and its dimensions are t square. Okay, so m l t power minus 2. This power I am taking into numerator. Okay? Upon time dimension t. Now, this t also take into numerator. It will become mLt power minus 3. So, dimensions of A should be, dimensions of A should be mLt power minus 3. Where option is there? These are A, these are B. So, this should be the right answer. Now, remaining B, second option, third option, fourth option are not having this dimension. So, this may be correct. This is correct. And which dimensions also I am trying to check now. Got it? How to get? Okay. Dimensions of A. Did you watch? Understood now? Dimensions of A. How to find? Understood now? First. Yeah, option 1. Abdul. Good. Abhay. Good. Option 1 is right answer. So dimensions of A we have got. Okay. Dimensions of A. A dimensions should be m l t power minus 3 we have got. Okay sir. Now I want dimensions of B. This. Again what we should do? F dimension should be equal to B into T square dimension. Okay. So B dimension should be equal to F dimensions upon T square dimension. Okay. F dimension means m l t power minus 2. Just now we have given. We have got. Upon T square dimension. So, what you will get? MLT power minus 4. Yes. So, this should be the answer. Okay. This is a way method to find dimensions of unknown quantity by using principle of homogeneity. Here, I hope you understand. You students, you understood this one. Okay. Good. Now, I am taking randomly one more question also. One more question I will take so that there will be no confusion for you. So principle of homogeneity, what it says, Nana? It says that dimensions of all the terms in an equation, all the terms of the equation, dimension should be same. Okay? Yeah. Now I am taking one important question. Let us see how many of you can solve this question. Question I am giving. I am taking something S is equal to, I tell you what it is, okay? S is equal to B T e power A T square. Just I have given like it is exponent power. Okay. Here, I am saying that here, S is distance you take. You take distance. Okay. And T is time you take. Here, you take S is distance, T is time. I want dimensions of B and A, question mark. I want dimensions of B and A. Clear? Yes. How to solve, sir? Here it is not having sum of the terms. Here it is not having sum of the terms. Yes or no? Yes, it is not having sum of the terms. But it is having only one term. This total is considered as one term. Yes or no? Yes. And one more important point is, here we have got exponent, E we have got, okay? And Michelle has given one answer, let me do this. Let us see what is the B answer, okay? E is not having any dimension, E is exponent. E is exponent, which is not having any dimension. E is a dimensionless quantity. Nana. E is a dimensionless quantity. E is a dimensionless quantity. So if it is to be dimensioned as quantity, this total dimension should become zero. Okay, just it is a number, means it should become e power zero, then only it will be a dimensionless quantity. Not e power zero, it should become one. E power one means dimensions of AT should become one. It should become e power one. Dimensions answering, not value. Okay, that means dimensions of A into T square should be equal to one. One more time. See, what I am saying is, F is equal to B into T e power A T square I have given. I want the dimensions of B and A. See, this F should is equal to total one term only. Means this total term dimension should be equal to this dimension. This total term dimension should be equal to this dimension. Okay na? Clear? Okay? Yes. Now this always, whatever is the exponent is a always dimensionless quantity. Exponent is always a dimensionless quantity. Means here a t square we should get one, then only it will become exponent dimensionless quantity. Here e power a t square is there, this dimension a t square dimension should be equal to one, then only it will become a dimensionless. Got it? Clear? Okay, that means A T square dimension should be equal to 1. Means A is equal to 1 by T square. 1 upon T, dimensions are T, capital T. Means T power minus 2. Means dimensions of A should be equal to T power minus 2. So t power minus 2, it will become e to the power of t power minus 2, this is t square, it will become e power 1, simply t. That means your equation will become s is equal to bt into e, it will become. Clear? Now e is a dimensionless quantity. E is a dimensionless quantity. Clear? Now, then BT dimension should be equal to S. B into T dimension should be equal to S. Then B dimension should be equal to S upon time. So dimensions I am writing, S dimensions are length and time dimensions are T. So its dimension will become L T power minus 1. Got it? Clear? Whenever we are having exponent like this, this total dimensions multiplied should get 1 in exponent. Because dimensions of exponent is nothing. It is not having any dimension. Okay? So A T square should dimension should become 1. When it will become, when A dimension will become T power minus 2. When A dimension will become T power minus 2, then only it will become 1. A dimensions are T power minus 2. Now what about B dimension? BT total dimension should be equal to S. Because this total is not dimensionless, it is a dimensionless quantity. Students will get confusion when you see this type of question. That's why I am explaining. Okay? Okay? Yeah. So if here M is not there, means you can keep M power 0 also. Okay na? Abhay, whatever you are giving it is wrong. M power 0, L T power minus 3 is wrong na. Yes. Mission is changed, yes sir, understood. Still anybody is having doubt in this? Are you having any doubt? Understood? No, this. Whenever E is there, E to the power of, that all this quantity dimension should be equal to 1. Because always, it is a necessary condition that E is a constant term. It is a dimensionless quantity. So E to the power of exponent dimension should be equal to 1. So 1. So T power minus 2. Okay, Abdul, what is your doubt? Okay, yeah. What is understood now? Yes. Important point. Keep it in mind. Keep it in mind. Okay? Yeah. So this is what we call it as uses of principle of homogeneity. How we can use this principle of homogeneity to solve the objective problems. Abdul is saying that if instead of E, if there is another variable, if another variable, we should solve. Okay? Clear? Yeah. Now, I am going to another point. If you want, still if you want, I can give you question. Here question is there. But if I want to solve this, you should know dimensions of pressure, volume, universal gas constant, these are things. Still you don't know. That's why I am leaving this question. Okay? I want... Here still I am not finding question, Anna. Best example is, this is first question what I have given, no? That is only the best example according to me for you. So if you want still, I will give you one more example. Let us start, because I want to make you to mastery on that point, okay? Yeah. So I want something velocity is equal to, V is equal to, I am giving something A, F. Yeah. AS plus BT plus C S by T. Okay. This is what I have given. One example I have given. Okay. Here V is equal to velocity. V is equal to what, Nana? Velocity. I am taking S is distance. You take T is time you take. Clear? Yes. These are all the known values you know. Okay. I am telling you that V means velocity. In my equation, what I have given, S means distance. T means time. I want dimensions of A, dimensions of B, dimensions of C. These are all dimensions I want. Can you calculate? Yes, sir. Why not? So, dimensions of V should be equal to dimensions of A into S. Yes or no? Yes, first thing. So, A dimension should be equal to V dimensions upon S dimension. V dimensions what? V is velocity. Velocity means L T power minus 1 upon distance is L. Means L cancel T power minus 1. Okay, nah? So A dimension should be T power minus 1. If you want to write, if you want to show that mass and length dimensions also, A dimensions, exact dimensions will become M power 0, L power 0, T power minus 1. These are the exact dimensions of A. Okay, B dimensions what? V dimensions should be equal to B dimensions and time. Means V dimension should be equal to V dimension upon T dimension. Okay, V dimensions are equal to, V dimensions are L T power minus 1 upon T dimensions are T. Okay, now V dimensions are L T power minus 2. If you want exactly, you can write it as M power 0, L T power minus 2. I hope you are understanding now. Slowly, slowly you are understanding. Okay? Now, I want C dimensions, sir. Yes, okay. V dimension should be equal to C into S by T dimension. Okay. So, C dimension should become V dimensions upon S by T dimension. okay. V dimensions what? L t power minus 1 upon x dimensions are L upon t power minus 1. So what you will get, sir? This will get cancelled. You will get t power minus 2. Yes or no? I think you are sending the messages about this. Okay, three dimensions are L square t power minus 2 is wrong. Michelle, C is wrong. B is correct. C is wrong. Okay, na? Clear? Yeah. So that means m power 0, l power 0, t power minus 2. These are the dimensions of C. Okay, one by one. So what to do? Sum of the terms, all the dimensions should be same. That is the meaning. So still, if you are facing some problem for the dimensions, just write the unit and cancel them. Last step, sir, this step. L t power minus 1 upon s by t. L by, sorry. Yeah, sorry. Yes, yeah. C. T, no? Here it is C. Okay? Yes. So, it will become t power minus 1 into t, nana. Means t power 0 also. Okay? Means C is a dimensionless quantity. Yes. C is a dimensionless quantity. Yes, a small mistake I have done here. C is a dimensionless quantity. This also will get cancelled. Sir, no, yes. C is a dimensionless quantity. Why, sir? S by T is what? Velocity. V is also velocity. Velocity will cancel. C is a just constant. C is a constant just. Okay, na? What? Good, good, Sanjana. Sanjeev, no? Sorry. Good, Sanjeev, good. So, S by T, no, velocity, distance by time is velocity. This is also velocity. This dimension gets cancelled. You will get S is a dimensionless quantity. C is a just constant, number it is. Clear? Okay? Yes. Now, let us go to one important topic of this point. This is about how to solve the objective problems, sir. This is how to solve objective problems. Okay. Now I am going to subjective point of view. That is uses of dimensional analysis. Uses of dimensional analysis. It is an important point. Important for your board exam 5 marks. They are asking repeatedly. If you write the uses and explain them, you will get 5 marks question. They may ask for 3 marks also. Just you can write the, what are the uses. Okay? I am writing one by one. You have to understand it carefully. Okay? So, why we will use this dimensional analysis? Why we will use that? First point, we will use this dimensional analysis to check the correctness of a given equation. One equation is given for you. Whether the given equation is correct or wrong, you can come to know by checking the dimensions on all the sides of the equation. Okay? This is one of the main use of dimensional analysis. Okay? And I will discuss in detail about this after explaining this remaining 2 points. Okay. Second point is we can derive the relation between physical quantities. We can able to derive some relations between the physical quantities by using this dimensional analysis. And third one is to convert one system of units into another system of units. If you write these 3 lines, 1, 2, 3, you will get 3 marks. these three, you will get 3 marks. This is a board exam, very important, Anna. It is a repeated question for board exam. Repeated question for board exam. You must bahat, not to bahat, just understand. You can remember this. Okay? Now, if you explain in detail about each and every point, then you'll get 5 marks. Okay? I'll explain in detail and about each and every point. Okay? So, what are the use, Anna? First use is, we can check the correctness of the given equation. Whether the equation is correct or wrong, we can check. Second use is, we can derive some equations. We can derive the equations. Means, we can derive some relation between the physical quantities. We can derive them also. And third equation, third use is, we can convert one system into another system. That means, we can convert MKS system of unit into CGS system, CGS to FPS, FPS to MKS, MKS to CGS, CGS to SI system, SI to CGS system. From one system to another system, we can convert by using dimensional analysis. So these are the uses of dimensional analysis. Okay, let us discuss, sir, when we have to come to college for subjective notes. After finishing up your classes, all the classes, you can come and take them. So, take from biology, sir. Huh? Okay? Ready, no?
Yes.
And one more thing, I am going to explain in detail about this one. It is very important for your board exam. Board exam for 5 marks. Okay? And now your second chapter is going to be end within 2 classes or 1 or 2 classes only. Now time is less than 1 minute is there, na? That's why I have stopped teaching this in detail. And one more announcement is that soon, very soon, I am going to conduct an exam also. Shall I take exam? Why I am waiting is because you are not having any material. Some members still they didn't take the material. That's why. Okay? Because some students they are not having material. No, what they will read? Some students they took material, almost 10-20 students. But some students they didn't take the material. If you have material, you can read, Nana. Okay, na? So yes, time is less than 1 minute, Nana. It is going to be end. So why it will start within seconds, it will end. Okay.